Robin Kurian, and you are watching Run It With Robin. We are here at the United Palace Theater for the premiere screening of Angelfish. All right, guys, I am here with Peter Lee. You directed, written, you wrote it, and you produced your baby, Angelfish.
Yeah.
So how are you feeling tonight? This is the premiere here at the beautiful United Palace, my first time here.
It's incredible. This venue is incredible. And that it's so close to where we shot the film as well.
When you wrote the movie, did you want it to be a Latina and a white Irish boy falling in love?
From the beginning, I had the inspiration of a true love story from Ireland. And what I wanted to do was set it in this incredible city that inspired me. And one of the big thing about the two characters is that they're two characters that are completely in love but come from completely different worlds.
The cast was so great. They're so easy, so wonderful. Everybody was just focused on doing a really good work.
Yeah.
And nobody was, you know, stuck in any preconceived ideas of what it should be or look like.
Okay.
And everything was fluid, and so there was a lot of space for creativity.
You play Brendan in this love, it's a New York City love story. How was it being on screen, you know, with Princess Nokia, Destiny, I should say?
It was absolutely incredible, and she's from this world.
Did she take you around to like where she grew up?
A little bit. We were walking around some of the areas, and I had my car. We were driving back and forth, so we were driving. We were listening to music, and we were driving through the Bronx. And
what were you listening to? Just curious.
Oh, man. Well, it was really cool. So we were just talking about some of the music from our formidable years, you know, and we were listening to the same things. And I vividly remember just jamming out to, like, Incubus.
What's the one thing that you want the audience to take away from watching this film?
You can be who you are, and it's okay. And don't be afraid to try and to dream and to go for it and to be ambitious and to have goals, even if they sound silly to other people or not, you know, practical or anything like that. It's possible.
I'm a Bronx supporter. I'm from, born and raised in the South Bronx myself.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, before I moved to New Jersey.
Okay.
And so, you know, I support my culture. I support where I came from.
You're actually Princess Nokia, one of her backup dancers.
Yes.
But you're actually in the film with her for Angelfish.
Yes, I am. I'm so excited.
Yeah, so how was it? You perform with her on stage on a regular, but how was it acting with her?
It's a different ball game, you know. Destiny is about her work.
Yeah.
And she takes it seriously. And you gotta be serious. You gotta be dedicated.
We know you as Princess Nokia, but you play Eva in Angelfish. Congratulations, this is your first acting debut. How did you, I know you didn't want people to look at you as the artist, so what was the challenge playing Eva?
The challenge was to create a role and a person that was not cool or wild, who was very much like Princess Nokia. I wanted to make her a character all of her own that was very true to the script, and I wanted to, she was inspired by the girls that I went to school with, the girls who I wasn't like, the girls who got their homework done on time and were reserved and were secular and careful with their surroundings and with people and with men.
Are you friends with those girls?
I wasn't, but I admired them. I admired that they were first generation Latinas who were making their parents proud, who had a lot of pressure. You know, my parents went to Tunnel and had a good time. My dad wanted me to be a hippie and wanted me to do anything I wanted to do. And
I love that.
Yeah, so I wanted to humanize what it is to be a child of an immigrant, to have the expectancy to do well and to make your mom proud. And that's what my character is. That's what she's the most notable. She's a good daughter. She's a good daughter who listens. And I've always been a good daughter, but I never listened. So
neither did I, girl. But congratulations. I'm excited to see
you. This is my first lead role film, and it means a lot to me to create a new boundary for women like myself and visibility on film. So I just want to say thank you to everyone who supports me.